Hi, welcome to Theory of Computation. In this session, we will discuss about mutual induction. In mutual induction, we have a group of statements S1 of n, S2 of n, etc. up to Sk of n, and together we will use based on the induction on n. What is the difference between the mutual induction and the general induction? In general induction, we have a single statement S of n, and we will use several bases on this induction statement. That is S of I, S of I plus 1, etc. up to S of j, and j is greater than or equal to I. But here we have different statements altogether. S1 of n is different from S2 of n and so on. So to understand the mutual induction, we will use a toggle switch. A toggle switch is something when you can push it once from the off state, the switch will get to the on state, and from the on state, if you push it once again, it will come to the off state. It is similar to what we have in the refill pen. Okay, if we push the pen, the nib will come out, and when we push it once again, the nib will go inside, right? A very similar operation. Initially, we are in the off state. When we push the switch, the machine will go from the off state to the on state, or you can imagine like the light is getting on, and then when you push the switch once again, the light will get off. Okay, so this is the operation of a toggle switch, and we will state the statements S1 of n and S2 of n. S1 of n states that the automaton is in the off state after n pushes, if and only if n is even. And S2 of n says the automaton is in the on state after n pushes, if and only if n is odd. Now, since this is an if and only if statement, we can split this into two parts for proving. So, S1 of if part is, if n is even, then the automaton is in the off state after n pushes. And S1 of only if part is, the automaton is in the off state after n pushes, if n is even. Similarly, the S2 if part is, if n is odd, then the automaton is in the on state after n pushes. And the only if part of S2 is, if the automaton is in the on state after n pushes, then n is odd. Before proving the statements, let's understand if then and if and only if. In if then, we have a hypothesis and a conclusion. And the entire statement if hypothesis then conclusion will be true. When hypothesis is true, then the conclusion is also true. If hypothesis is true, the conclusion should be true. Then the entire statement if hypothesis then conclusion will be true. If hypothesis is true and the conclusion is false, the entire statement is going to be false. For the conclusion to be true, the hypothesis need not be true. So in this combination also, the entire statement is true. And if hypothesis is false and the conclusion is false, then also the entire statement is true. So, given a hypothesis and a conclusion, the entire statement if hypothesis then conclusion will be false only when the hypothesis is true and the conclusion is false. For the rest of the values, it is all true. Notably, if hypothesis is false, we need not worry about the value of conclusion. The entire statement will be true. And if you consider if and only if statements, we have two statements A and B, and the entire statement is A if and only if B. When will the statements be true? If A is true, then B has to be true, and if A is false, then B has to be false. That is what is illustrated here. If A is false and B is false, then the entire statement is true. Otherwise, if A is true, then B has to be true to make the entire statement true. The other combination, if any one of the value is false, then the entire statement will be false. This is if and only if statements. Now let's go on prove the induction statements that we have stated. Since the induction is based on the number of pushes, the n equal to 0 is the trivial case, which is the basis. Now what is S1 of if part? If n is even, then the machine should be, the automaton will be in off state after n pushes. We know that n is even because n is equal to 0, and we know that 0 is even. So 0 pushes means we are not even pushing the switch. That means that the machine will be in the start state. And what is the start state? It is the off state. If you recall the picture, the start state is the off state. So we will be in the off state in 0 pushes. That's what is stated here. So when n is even, we are in the off state. The only if part is, the machine is in the off state after n pushes, and we have to show that n is even. And with 0 pushes, we are indeed in the start state, which is an off state. And we know that when there is no push, n is equal to 0, that means that n is even, because 0 is even. Similarly, if you consider the S2 of if part, the hypothesis is that if n is odd, then the automaton will be in the on state after n pushes. But now the according to the basis, n is 0 and 0 is not odd. That means that hypothesis is false. If hypothesis is false, then the entire statement if hypothesis, then conclusion is true. That is what we have seen in the table. If hypothesis is false, irrespective of the value of conclusion, the entire statement will be true. So we exploit this and state, since n is odd is false because n is equal to 0 and 0 is even, we say that the entire statement if n is odd, then the automaton is in the on state after n pushes is true. Similarly, S2 of only if part is, the automaton is in the on state after 0 pushes, which is false, because when we do not even push, then the machine is in the off state, that is the start state, which is an off state. So the hypothesis is false. Therefore, the conclusion, if the entire statement, if the automaton is in the on state after n pushes, then n is odd is true. This is how we establish the basis. Now we will assume that S1 of n and S2 of n are true, and we wanted to prove the statements for n plus 1 pushes for S1 and S2. And the inductive step is like this. S1 n plus 1 if statement is, if n plus 1 is even, then the automaton is in the off state after n plus 1 pushes. So given the hypothesis is n plus 1 is even, that means that n is odd. If n is odd, then from S2 of n if part, we know that the automaton is in the on state after n pushes. That is, S2 of n if part is, if n is odd, the automaton will be in the on state after n pushes. This we have assumed. Since we have assumed S2 of n, this S2 of n if part is also true. And since n is odd, then we know that we are currently in on state. Then after n pushes, then for n plus 1, we have one more push to go from on state to the off state. So the n plus 1th push from on state will bring the automaton from on state to off state. And this is what we have to prove. The only if part of S1 is, the hypothesis is the automaton is in the off state after n plus 1 pushes. Then we have to prove n plus 1 is even. So when the automaton is in the off state after n plus 1 pushes, we know that n is greater than 0 because we have a plus 1 here. So when n is greater than 0, we can get to the off state in only one way. That is, the automaton is in the on state and then it receives a push input and thereby we come here. Okay, that is, we are in the on state because n is greater than 1. Okay, so we are in the on state and we receive a push input and that makes us come to the off state. So the automaton is in the off state after n plus 1 pushes imply that the automaton is in the on state after n pushes. This means that from the hypothesis of S2 of n, only if part, we know that if the automaton is in the on state after n pushes, then we know that n is odd. When n is odd, we know that n plus 1 is even. Thereby, we are able to establish if the automaton is in the off state after n plus 1 pushes, then n plus 1 is even. Now, we will prove the S2 statements. The proof is very similar to S1 statements. We have to just exchange the role of S1 and S2 and odd and even. That's all. So S2 of n plus 1 if part is, the hypothesis is this one. N plus 1 is odd. If n plus 1 is odd, then the automaton is in the on state after n plus 1 pushes. So the given part is n plus 1 is odd, which implies that n is even. If n plus 1 is odd, then n is even. Then if n is even, we know that the automaton will be in the off state after n pushes from the statement S1 of n if part. So S1 of n if part states that if n is even, then the automaton will be in the off state after n pushes. If this is the case, then the nth plus 1th push, that is after n we have one more push in n plus 1, right? That push will cause the automaton from the off state to enter the on state. That is the if part. And only if part, the hypothesis is the automaton is in the on state after n plus 1 pushes, and we have to prove that n plus 1 is odd. In this case, n is clearly greater than 0 because we have a plus 1 here. And the only way to get into on state is that we should be in the off state after n pushes, and the last push, that is n plus 1th push, will make us to move to the on state. So the automaton is in the on state after n plus 1 pushes, imply that the automaton was in the off state after n pushes. This means that I know from S1 of n only if part, if the automaton is in the off state after n pushes, then we know that n is even. If n is even, then n plus 1 has to be odd. Thereby we have established that if the automaton is in the on state after n plus 1 pushes, then n plus 1 should be odd. Thus we have proved by mutual induction the statements S1 of n and S2 of n for n plus 1. In the next video, we will see the construction of finite automata. Thank you for watching this video.